Wherever he leads, I'll go. I'll follow my Christ who loves me so. Wherever he leads, I'll go. Wherever he leads, I'll go.
Trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal bright and fair. When the saved of earth shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll
is called up yonder, I'll be there.
Called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. On that bright and cloudless morning, when the dead in Christ shall rise and the glory of his resurrection share, when his chosen ones shall gather to their home beyond the skies, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
Burn with strong desires
thy return. With such I hasten to the place where God my Savior shows his face, and gladly take my stay. Hour of prayer, sweet hour of prayer, and wait for thee, sweet hour of prayer. Precious memories, unseen angels sent from somewhere to my soul. How they linger ever near me,
and the sacred past. Just over the hilltop, in that bright land where we'll never grow old, and someday yonder we will never more wander, but walk the streets that are pure as gold.
But you worship. You open your heart. and you start worshiping, and you're imagining that you're giving God glory. You're imagining, you know, where two or more gathered, so am I. He's here.
Yeah.
And a lot of times, if you look at me, my eyes will be closed. And I'm imagining, where is he here? And I'm reaching out for him. And when I do this, folks, when I do this, all at once I can feel a moving of the Spirit in me. And sometimes I can't, because sometimes that stumbling block in my life is awful big. But it's important that we get a grasp, we get our head wrapped around why we worship. And once that Spirit starts moving, once that Holy Spirit joins in and kicks that stumbling block out of the way, then the minister, the preacher, or you or me, man, the Spirit starts moving. That's when he's taking over. That's when things happen. That's when these revivals in us take place. That's when that door is open.
Yeah.
A lot of times you'll hear, I pray, I'll say, God, open doors no man can open. Shut doors no man can shut. Why? Because we've got some doors in our life that we need shut. We got some doors in our life that we need open. All right, what's the next song? What's the next song?
Already Cross.
Oh, do you know what page?
No.
142. Oh, you jumped in on the spot there. The old 142 trick.
On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the and I will cling to the old brother. Yes, I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown.
Symbolizing the thirsty souls that were in the wilderness in that day. And that's what we're reminded of when they celebrate the Feast of the Tabernacles. And that's what they were celebrating here. And in the midst of that, Jesus recognized that. He sees an opportunity to slip a little phrase in there to try to show them who he was and what he does. And but the truth be known, every one of us has a thirsty soul. Our souls are thirsty. And we try to fill our souls with anything other than what our soul really needs. We try to take care of our body by putting stuff in our body, but that doesn't satisfy the soul. The soul has a need that the body can't satisfy.
Right.
And so Jesus knows this, and he's telling them in this, if you'll come and drink of this living water. And he said that many times. But if you go back to Exodus, we get a clear picture of this. Maybe you miss it when you read it. But back in Exodus, when they're traveling through the wilderness, and they hadn't gotten very far. They were only 3 or 4 days into the wilderness, and they find no water. Remember this? And Jesus says, tells Moses, he said, go and speak to the rock, and I'll bring water out of the rock to satisfy the thirst of the people. Now, he was talking about a physical thirst, but if you look deeper down into the concept, theologically, he wasn't really talking about a physical thirst. He was talking about a soul thirst is what he was talking about. Because the reason I say that is because when he did that, Moses was disobedient by striking the rock instead of speaking to the rock the way God told him to. And so Moses paid a price for that disobedience. And by the way, so will you when you disobey God. But he, nevertheless, he had the water come forth out of the rock, and the thirst of the people was satisfied for that time that they were there in the wilderness. And the Bible says that rock, listen to what it said. It said that rock still runs today. Why did it say that? It wasn't talking about that physical rock out in the desert that's still pouring out water. He was talking about the rock, Jesus Christ, that's still pouring. And here he is in John, thousands of years later, saying, if you'll come to me, the Holy Spirit will enter you, and out of your bellies, rivers of living water will flow. And that water is flowing from Jesus Christ, who was in the Old Testament as well as the New Testament. Does that make sense to you?
Yeah.
So, our souls long for our thirsty soul. Our souls are thirsty. But now what you've got to understand is if your life is troubled, if you've got devastation, heartache, sorrow in your life, and you can't seem to fix that problem, your problem is not a physical or a mental problem, it's a soul problem.
Yeah.
We try to put band-aids on everything that hurts within us, but really none of those things, some of them work temporarily, finding a new love or a great amount of money or whatever the world might try to satisfy you with, a new job, a new house, a new, whatever it might be, and that might temporarily fix what is ailing you. But the real thing is ailing you is not the physical things that you can acquire or the mental things. What really ails you is you've got a soul that's thirsty for God, and there's only one thing that can fill that soul. And so he's saying, if you will come to me, he says, come to me, all ye. I like what he said. He said, all ye who thirst. That means every one of us can come to Jesus. That'll take a drink of that water. They drank of it in the desert. The woman in John chapter 4, she came, and he says, woman, he said, if you'll drink of this water, the living water, you'll never thirst again. Why did he say that? Because he knew that if she would accept him as the Lord and Savior of her life, she would never thirst again, because that living water would be inside of her. Now, let me try to break this down real quick. I'll shut up. The body, your body, that you live in is what speaks to the world. That's where we get the metaphor, your body language. Your body tells the world a lot about you. Probably more than it should sometimes. You get to that a lot. So, but your body communicates with the world, if you will. The soul communicates with the inward you. Are you with me? And so you communicate with your soul, your body communicates with the world, but now you've got a spirit. You've got a spirit too, by the way.
Yeah.
Body, soul, and spirit. And your spirit is the one that talks to God. Are you clear on that? The body talks to the world. The soul talks to us individually. We talk to ourselves, to our soul. And the spirit talks to God. And Jesus, taking that analogy, here's what he does. He said, if you'll come to me and drink. Notice that word. It said, you must drink. In other words, what do you do when you drink? Well, a lot of us try to put salt water in our bodies instead of the real living water. We put stuff that don't need to be in our bodies. Right. For years, y'all are sitting there looking at me, and you know what I'm going to say.
Mm-hmm.
I drank stuff that I shouldn't have been drinking for years.
Right.
It wasn't what I needed for my soul, but what I was doing was trying to drown the sorrow and the real heartache that my soul longed for. He longed for it to be communed with God and with the Spirit, but the Spirit wasn't connecting with the soul because the soul was taking, and my body was taking in all those things that shouldn't be in the body, and so there was no communication with the body and the soul and the spirit. That's where we get in trouble. So Jesus knew, by the way, if anybody knows what your body needs, or your soul, or your spirit, it's God, because God is the one that made you. And so, he said, if you'll come and drink of this water that I'll give you and receive the Holy Ghost. So now, if you come to Christ, if you're saved tonight, and you drink of the living water, you met Christ and you've given your life and heart to Him, now your soul, watch this, your spirit, well, let me put it to you in the language, what he does. Real simple. Your car that you drove here tonight, it has a water pump on it. Does it not? Something has to engage that water pump to cause the water to flow through that pump and go out into the rest of the body of that car. Y'all follow me? But something has to engage that. Something, some mechanism has to initiate the flow of the water through the body of that car, through the water pump. So what God is saying is when you come and you drink of the living water, you got your body, you got your soul, and you got your spirit, but in the spirit, he takes a water pump, a spiritual water pump, and puts it out deep down into your spirit. And then that Holy Spirit, that water pump is fastened in you, and he puts it in you. When he comes to live inside of you, he's the pump. And so the pump is installed in you, if you will, when you become saved. But wait a minute. Just like your car, something has to start the pump. Are y'all still with me? Everybody okay? The only thing that you hit, well, go, you said it. The only thing that will start the pump and the river of water flowing in you is this right here. Thank you, Lord. Praise your name, Lord. Worshiping and praising God is what starts the pump of the Holy Ghost that lives in your spirit. And when it starts initiating and you start praising God, that's why you said that a while ago, because you're exactly right. When you get up there and you start praising God and God begins to move, that pump is there, and your spirit activates. activate that pump. Now, here's what happens. Your pump starts flowing, and your spirit is flooded.
Yeah.
Yeah. Your spirit is flooded, and now it's flooding your soul. It's flooding everything around. It's flowing. That's why he said your belly of living water flows. It's flooding everything in your soul and your spirit, and it's flooding. And now it's causing your body, because everything is coming through that body, the spirit and the soul, is causing your body to do things it never did before.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah. Because you are a new creature in Christ, and the Holy Spirit, the pump has been activated, and now it's flowing through you, and your body has never seen this before. It's never been activated before, because you never knew Christ before. But once God installed the pump and you got saved, the pump turned on, and when you started praising God, thank you, Jesus, for saving my soul, that pump kicks on and starts to pump, and the rivers of living water. Now watch this. When I was a kid, I remember seeing in town, in the hot summer, y'all are seeing this, especially in the inner city. Bunch of boys, bunch of kids will get around, and the fire department will come, and they'll open up a hydrant. Y'all know what happens. All the neighborhood kids is over there, and that stream of water is coming out of that hydrant, and they're running and slipping and sliding and jumping in that water and having a big old time. And what they don't realize is that stream of water that's about that big is coming out of a pump, or is coming out of that fire hydrant, and it's only about that big around. But what you've got to understand is that little stream of water that you see coming out of that pump is coming from a great big reservoir somewhere that holds a whole lot more water than that. And it's the same way when God initiates your pump, that little bit will flow out of you, but it's coming from a reservoir that only God can supply, and it's huge tonight, folks. There's a vast supply, and it never ends.
Yes. Amen. Amen.
So, when this woman came to Jesus at the well, she had no idea what was going on in her life. She was a wreck. She was ashamed to come to the well, but she sought water, physical water. But Jesus knew that she had a thirsty soul.
Yes.
And he wanted to install the pump in her life. Yes. Watch this now. And when she said, "You must be a prophet. You must be the Son of God," the pump kicked on. Yeah, you know why I know that? Because she got her engine running. She dropped the load she had and ran all the way back to town and told everybody in town, "I've met a man that's told everything about me. He must be the Son of God. This must be the Messiah." What was going on? Her pump had turned on, and the river of living water was coming out of her, and everybody around her wanted part of it.
Amen.
And they came back out to the well with her to meet this man that had given her the living water. The Holy Ghost had been installed in her. What I'm asking you tonight, has the Holy Ghost pump been installed? You see, if you can't come to me, Patty and I are talking about this tonight, coming to church, and sometimes I come in and I don't feel like worshiping, I don't feel like singing, I've had a rough day, things have been going wrong all day, I don't feel like getting up and singing like you love to, and I know I need to, because I know if I can't praise God, he's not going to turn my pump, ain't going to kick on, and I can't worship him the way I need to, so I have to tell myself, "Holy Ghost, I know you're there. I know you want to be activated. God, help me. Help my unbelief, God, and let me stand up and praise you for who you are." And when I get to thinking about that, that pump begins to kick on, and the river of living water begins to flow, and my soul is satisfied. The hungry, thirsty soul that's living inside of me.
Amen.
So tonight, we're going to dunk Jose in some water. I told him I was going to count to 100, hold him down. Well, what he's got and what you've got, you have a thirsty soul. And you heeded the words that Jesus said. And notice, you can't just worship. Let me give you this little bit of information. I'll let you go. You can't just worship here in church.
That's right.
No, your worship has got to be private and public.
Right.
In order for Jesus, in order for your Holy Ghost pump to activate, see, it's easy to get your motor running here, but you get up there on the corner square or in Walmart, and it's harder to get your pump going. Because you don't feel God around you. You don't feel His presence in your life. But if you will sit there and think, oh God, all these people around me, they may be lost, and they may need a drink of the living water. And God, let me be of use to you. Let me glorify your name. And when you start calling on the name of God and start glorifying His name, that pump kicks on, and you can tell everybody in Walmart that you belong to Jesus. I tell you tonight, we need a drink of that living water. It's imperative that the world gets a drink of that living water so that they can get their phone and song called the Holy Ghost. You see, you can get saved and you can sit on a pew all your life. You can. And you can go to heaven. But wouldn't it be sad to know when you got to heaven, if you never activated the pump that He installed in you and you never used it all your life, you sat there lifeless on a pew and never said amen, never said praise God, thank you Jesus. You never praised God. Your pump was never activated. You had it all your life, but you never used it. Wouldn't that be sad? To find out when you get to heaven, I didn't know how to praise God. I tell you what you will do. When you get to heaven, you can learn how to praise God. So you might as well get warmed up down here, because that's all you're going to do in heaven is praise Jesus. Jose, come on. Go ahead and get ready. I'll be back here in a minute. Yes. Inside of you, and you can't explain it. All you can do is sit there and say, thank you, Jesus, and something's going on inside of you. That's that pump overflowing, flooding everything in your soul, feeding a thirsty soul. Come on, Lord, let's sing. Let me ask you tonight, have you ever felt your pump activated? Have you ever just praised God with all that you are? And felt His presence so strong in your body that you didn't understand it. You felt it, but you didn't understand it. That's the Holy Ghost trying to come out in a river of living water. Go ahead, Dennis, just play. Would you stand with me?
Page 236. Hold on a minute, Dad. Just a little talk with Jesus. We can do this off the cover. Let's see how many pumps is running. See if we got any old seals.
Y'all come to Jesus. I'm going to go get ready. What y'all say?
All right, ready? I once was lost in sin.
tonight.
Yes.
Stare his demons down. And
There's a lot of us, we got stuff in our life. We got demons in our life. I've got demons in my life. I've got addictions. I've got drugs. I've got alcohol. I've got all this garbage. And there's times that I have to stare these demons down. I got to overcome this. You know, Scripture tells us that we got to put this flesh to death every day. And a lot of times when I see, like as Mickey said, he was baptized a long time ago, but it didn't mean much. Well, to me right now, when a gentleman goes in that water again, he's staring them demons down. And a lot of y'all know there's things in our life that it's hard to stare it down. It's hard to cut the head off of it. Things raise back up on us. This is an everyday thing. It's a long battle, but it's going to be worth it. It's going to be amazing when we cross that threshold into eternity. It's going to be wonderful. I heard Joe Don say one time, I look forward to going across Jordan. I look forward to this. All right, page 194. Have you got it on the screen? This might be a little harder because I can't hardly see these words.
Here, look up there.
What do you mean up there? There we are. All right. Here we go. I'm just weary.
Anything on your heart? Ain't God good?
Yeah.
back to the back door and stand and let them shake your hand on the way out.
Yes, sir.
All right. All right. Let's pray. Father, we thank you tonight for your precious word. Lord, you said come and drink. Lord, I'm so glad that you gave me an opportunity to do that, to get you to give me the Holy Ghost. Lord, what a blessing that is. Let it flow out of me, God, that others around me might want what I've got. Lord, bless Jose now in his life. Lord, let him walk with you every step of the way, and knowing that you're right there beside him. Use him for your glory. Let him praise you everywhere he goes. Thank you, Jesus, tonight for salvation. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen.